So today my project is about campfires, as in the picture. The scientific method is made up of 7 steps. The first is make an observation. The second is think of interesting questions. Third is make your hypothesis. The fourth is make testable predictions. The fifth is develop experiment. The sixth is gather data. And the seventh is present. So for making observations, I made an observation that I've gathered together by several campouts that I've been on, and is that some ways to start a fire are better than others. And so I know this because I've been camping for a while now, and I especially noticed it when we were doing campfires in Scouts. And so for Scouts, at the end, we had a competition to see who could start a fire the quickest. And we had to choose 10 materials. We had to choose 10 things out of these 4 materials. The materials were toilet paper, shredded paper, pine straw, and tinder. Tinder is another word for little sticks that help your fire start. And so I chose 5 pieces of shredded paper, 1 piece of toilet paper, and 4 pieces of tinder. So, for example, if you started out a fire like this, it wouldn't really be burning because the sticks are too big and it has way too much oxygen, so it would end up quickly in ashes. This right here is a good example. If the sticks were smaller and skinnier, then it would be a good fire if you had fire starter. Fire starter is a material that you use to help a fire start. And so, as you can see, there are little spaces in the pile of sticks that give the fire oxygen to keep going, and eventually this would start burning. So my interesting questions are, what is the best way to start a fire? Which material will win the race? How long will it take for each material to light on fire? Why haven't I thought of this before, and will I accidentally burn myself in the test? My hypothesis is, I think the best way to start a fire is by using dryer. This is dryer lint. It's stuff that comes off of your clothes in the dryer, and you have to collect it out. So my testable prediction is that I think that dryer lint will win the race, as in my hypothesis, but it will win the race even if I put bigger sticks on it than the others. And it's harder for a fire to start with bigger sticks on it because it doesn't have really a place to start on because it's so big. So while I was developing the experiment, I came up with this test. For the experiment, I started 3 different campfires. And so one of them had pine straw, the other was using toilet paper, and the other was using jar. So I put all little sticks on them, except for the jar one. I put bigger sticks, but not too big where it couldn't light. And so I gathered my data, and I put it together. The pine straw took 1 minute and 13.47 seconds to light. Toilet paper took 36.80 seconds to light. And dryer lint won with 35.44 seconds. And it won even if it had bigger sticks on it, under the same conditions that were on the stick. This might not work for every day because it might be raining some days. It's still possible to start a fire, but it's harder, and so others might last longer. So today, some of the vocabulary words that I gathered together was campfire. Campfire is a fire that you use for a campout. A campout is somewhere that you go into the wilderness, as in, most of the time it's a forest. You might go somewhere else for a limited amount of time. Tinder, like I told you, is another word for little sticks that start fire. And fire starter in the name is something that helps a fire start. So thanks for watching, but I have something for all of us to do. So if everybody can come up, please.